Now, Andrew, State of Origin, we mentioned that. We'll get a bit more on that in a moment with the aged care minister of all people. But you spoke yesterday about the Voice and the fact that the No campaign had been having a few similarities with the Coalition. What's the latest on that front?
Well, yes, I mentioned this. The convergence, if you like, of the No campaign and the opposition's tactics in Question Time. Overnight, we've had an email distributed widely from Peter Dutton containing an anti-Voice missive from John Howard asking for donations to the Liberal Party to help campaign against the Voice. Mr Howard says in this email, quote, "Like most people, I am in favour of constitutional recognition of Indigenous Australians. However, what is being proposed is a Voice that can speak to every part of the federal government with the potential for recommendations to be litigated if they are rejected. This could create a constitutional quagmire. There is a risk that a future High Court could place an interpretation on the Voice which goes beyond the current expectations of the government." So Mr Dutton encloses this John Howard letter. He calls for donations and says, quote, "We know, however, that the Yes case will be backed by millions of dollars of advertising. Every dollar donated here will go to communicating key messages about the Voice to Australians." Now, Indigenous Australians Minister Linda Burney has been under attack in Question Time from the opposition. They believe she's not adequately explaining what the Voice will provide advice on. They see a target here, and we very much saw that occur again today.
Did the minister mislead the parliament when she said, and I quote, "I can tell you what the Voice won't be giving advice on. It won't be giving advice on changing Australia Day."
This is not about culture wars. This is about closing the gap.
Would the Voice have the power to advise the government to abolish Australia Day?
The Voice will not be bothered by culture wars.
Can the minister name an issue that affects non-Indigenous Australians that does not affect Indigenous Australians?
Mr Speaker, there is no reference in the question to the responsibilities of the minister. No. Not one.
There is no ambiguity whatsoever about the question being in order. It is within the scope of the minister's portfolio, with or without reference to the Voice.
Just look at the bottom score of every social rung of every social ladder in this country and you might figure that out. I am not interested in culture wars. I am interested in closing the gap.
Order. Order. So pretty fiery in there. Well, one of the fathers of the Voice, Noel Pearson, spoke to me earlier this month about how he believed the Voice would work. Can you give us a few examples about how the Voice, you see the Voice working?
It's got to enable those communities to sit down with the Commonwealth government and hopefully with the state government as well and the local government. And we need to make deals. They need to make deals about the football oval, about the housing situation, about the children not attending school, about the curfew hours for children roaming around the streets. They make decisions about the initiatives they're going to take to address those problems.
What about a job seeker rise or something like that? Do you see that as something the Voice would advise on?
The Voice will provide advice on that, along with everybody else's advice.
Okay.
And guess who gets to decide what weight to give it? It's our elected representatives.
Indeed.